Okay, today I suppose to start triple integration. So you see, in double integration, in line integration, what you integrate, whatever you have to integrate, you are going through a curve, a line. Line integration means the integration with along a curve, along a line, along a curve C. Double integration means you are integrating along a region R. Here, along a curve like this. Here, along a region like this. Okay. Now we will come to triple integration. That will be along a volume. That will be along a volume element like this. Okay. So triple integration will be along a volume like this. Please, all of you, mute your microphone.
चलो सर, अपनी अपनी मर्जी है,
क्या कर रहा है?
अपना अपना इंटरेस्ट है सर।
कैन यू जस्ट स्विच ऑफ योर माइक्रोफोन?
आई एम सॉरी, प्लीज डोंट इंटरप्ट द क्लास।
एग्जैक्टली।
सर यू म्यूट अस ऑल।
अनमोल शर्मा, शर्मा
सर म्यूट ऑल सर।
टेंशन ही नहीं रहता तो
सॉल्व करेंगे, तो तुम्हारा कोई क्वेश्चन होगा तो नहीं आएगा।
नहीं सर, क्योंकि हम लोग आंसर
सर
इज नाउ म्यूटेड
सर।
वो टेम्पररी होता
ओके नाउ 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 लेट्स मी स्टार्ट। सो वॉल्यूम विल बी अलोंग, सो ट्राई टू रिमेंबर लाइक दिस, लाइन इंटीग्रेशन अलोंग ए लाइन, रीजन इंटीग्रेशन मीन्स अलोंग ए रीजन, एंड वॉल्यूम इंटीग्रेशन अलोंग ए वॉल्यूम। दिस इज द path. Okay, path is here curve, here a region, here a volume. So suppose you have the volume integration will be given like this, triple integration v f of x y z a function, and this is suppose dv. Here dv you can represent as a volume like f of x y z dx dy dz. So what we will have, suppose this is the coordinate axis, suppose this is the coordinate axis, along this I am considering x axis, this y axis, this is z axis suppose, and there is a volume here along which you need to integrate. This is a volume here suppose, along this volume you need to integrate. Along this volume you need to integrate. So what we will do, this total volume, suppose total volume is V, I am representing. Now you can subdivide this volume along x axis, along y axis, along z axis, like this sub intervals. You can do this sub intervals. So x axis subdivided into suppose x0, x1, x2 up to xn points. Y is subdividing into y0, y1 up to yn points, and z subdivided into z0, z1 up to zn points. Like this, if you subdivide, this volume, so what will happen now? Suppose there is a particular volume element, small volume element I am considering in this here. This is suppose small volume element I am considering. This is suppose delta V I J K. This is a small volume area delta V I J K I am considering here. Now you are and any point in between this volume element, that is suppose some xi eta j, and suppose zeta, I am writing zeta k. Suppose this is a small, this is a point in between this volume. So the point value here will be some xi I, eta I, and zeta k. And if you take this product and take summation, three summations, If you take three summation, one is from I is equal to 1 to m, j is from 1 to n, and k is from 1 to suppose some p. Okay. Sorry, here this will be n, this will be m, and this is suppose some p. This may be different. Okay. So, this now if delta Vijk, these are the small volumes, if I consider as similar, this is similar, the just I am extending the concept of double integration. Now, if you consider the all the small volume as some delta V is equal to maximum of this all delta Vijk, and if you take delta V tends to delta V tends delta V tends to 0, then this integration actually represented by this things. Now, so you cannot, in surface integration, in line integration, if you consider there, that will be area under curve. The double integration means area, volume under that surface. Now, triple integration, that in fourth dimensional case you consider, that fourth dimension, that is not be, cannot be visible. So, you can say the hypervolume or hypersurfaces. Okay. So, this is the concept that this is equal to this one. And here also, we can extend the all the concept of double integration, that suppose integration, we have to integrate along this V, f of x, y, z, dx, dy, dz, that you can write as some, suppose x is equal to a to b, then y is equal to c to d, if a rectangular type form is there, z is equal to some e to f of x, y, z, dx, dy, dz. This x is equal to a to b is range for x, y is equal to c to d is range for y, and z is equal to e to f ranges of df. So simply, if I take one example here, suppose you are asked to find this integration, volume integration of the integrand is x cube y square z with respect to dx dy dz. And V is given the x, y, z point such that x varies from 0 to a, y varies from 0 to x, and z varies from 0 to y. So, simply you just write down this is equal to, this is a simple integration, x is equal to 0 to a, y is equal to 0 to x, and z is equal to 0 to y. Then we have x cube y square z dx dy dz. You see, as x ranges from 0 to a, so first we integrate with respect to z, so that we will get a function of y. Then with respect to y, so that we will get a function of x. And finally, with respect to x. So this can be represented as, this is equal to, if I write, first integration will be x is equal to, for last integration will be x equal to 0 to a, this is, then you write y is equal to 0 to x, then you write z is equal to 0 to y, then x cube y square z, first with respect to z, then with respect to y, then with respect to x. So now, just one by one you integrate and you will get the value, x equal to 0 to a, y is equal to 0 to x, this integration will be x cube, y cube, z, integration of z is z square by 2.
Sir, y square.
Z square by 2, y square, this one is y square, z square by 2. And this is from 0 to y dy then dx. So that is equal to integration, you can write x equal to 0 to a, y is from 0 to x, this will be the value will be x cube, y if you put y square, that is y to the power 4, that is x cube y to the power 4 by 2. By 2 dy, then finally dx. So, half you can take out. So, 1 by 2, if I am taking out, then this will be x equal to 0 to a. If you integrate with respect to y, this will be 1 by 5 x cube y to the power 5, that is x to the power 8. X to the power 8 dx. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So 1 by 10, then x to the power 8 integration will be x to the power 9 by 10. This will be 90, will be 90 and a to the power
9.
Okay. So the value will be this. So integration value will be this. So you see, first, this is important that this you can writing actually by as a repeated integration that as we have done in double integration. So you can write in this repeated integration form and you can then solve. So now let me go to the next example.
Sir,
suppose you are asked,
sir, can I be the first slide? So here so the order of this summation, that is summation I equals to 1 to n, j equals to 1 to m, k equals to 1 to p. So can we change this, like in the first is k equals to 1 to p, then j equals to 1 to m, then I equals to 1 to n, or it all?
You can change. Accordingly, this dx, dy, dz will be changed. Accordingly, this dx, dy volume element will change.
So I mean, their order will then change.
Actually, this delta V I j k, actually delta, if I write delta V I j k, this is actually nothing but delta X I into delta Y j into delta Z k volume.
Okay. Will it not cause any change in the answer? I mean, if I change the order of this sigma summation?
It may happen, the integration of the may happen getting changed, because last day I have given one example on double integration. There you see, just I have changed the order of integration and we are getting the different value. Plus, you have done one, cost out one example like this.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
So it may happen.
Sir, it was not continuous. That's why we got different values.
Yes, sir.
If it is not continuous, in that case, you will get different values.
Oh, yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, how now can we use this summation? Please use any problem. How can we use this summation?
I'm not getting.
In any problem, how can we use this triple summation?
In any problem, how can you use triple summation means?
Triple
summation. What are you asking for?
Yeah.
एग्जांपल लेके मतलब तुम बोल रहे हो कि इस समेशन करके एग्जांपल
या
सो समेशन यू कैन नॉट फाइंड दैट्स व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग दिस डेफिनेशन इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल टू गेट दिस समेशन वैल्यू
देन इट इज फॉर डेफिनेशन
इट विल बी नॉट आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट दिस विल बी नॉट पॉसिबल इट इज पॉसिबल बट देन द कैलकुलेशन विल बी देयर इज यू सी इन इन I think in HSA crossed out some problems that limit n tends to infinity, 1 by n by n squared, like this, you summation, this summation, you represent this as an integration and then find the value.
Yes, sir.
In your HS.
Yes, sir.
You see, there we have done a lot of calculation on this, then we get the values. For a simple problem, suppose simply if you take integration 0 to 1 x dx, for that, you need to write in summation form. In that case, you have to get laborious job. Okay, you can take one thing, you can just take this is a constant and you can get the values. But if you want, I can tell you in the next class also. Okay, now come back to this problem. So here, integrand is x plus y plus z plus 1. You have to integrate this. So function f of x, y, z is function f x, y, z is equal to x plus y plus z plus 1. This is your f of x, y, z. And volume is given, volume V is given for a tetrahedron bounded by x equal to 0, y is equal to 0, z is equal to 0, and x plus y plus z plus 1 is equal to z is equal to 1. If simply the range is given, then the problem will be easy. Okay, if the range is not given for x, y, z, a volume element is given like this, in that case you need to draw the volume first. And you have to judge what are the, you have to convert it into a repeated integration. You see, double integration and triple integration, both we can do by converting it to a repeated integration, not by just surface integration or volume integration. You have to convert it to a repeated integration. So for that, so what you need to do? So volume, this V you need to draw. So how can you draw this V? So what will be your V? So let me draw in XYZ plane. Suppose this is your X axis. I'm making this is Y axis. This is suppose Z axis. X is equal to 0. So can you tell me X equal to 0 in 3D, what does it represent actually? X equal to 0?
YZ plane.
So that means YZ, okay. That means YZ plane, Y is equal to 0 means ZY, ZX plane, and Z is equal to 0 means XY plane. So these three planes bounded, the volume bounded by these three plane and another plane, X plus Y plus Z is equal to 1. What this X plus Y plus Z is equal to 1 represent? You can write X by 1, Y by 1, Z by 1. That means the coordinate
intercept
of 100. This is 100. This is 010. And this is suppose 001. So bounded by these three coordinate. So the plane will be like this. This and this. So the volume is this volume. This is suppose O, the origin. So along this volume, you need to integrate. You need to integrate along this volume. So how can we write this volume? How can we write this volume? This is suppose x, y, z point such that, now what you'll do, you see, can I represent like this? Start from x axis. X varies from 0 to 1. As x varies from 0 to 1, if I write 0 less than equal to x less than equal to 1, as x varies from 0 to 1, y varies from where to where? As x varies from 0 to 1, y varies
0
from
to x.
This x axis
1 to
this x axis
0 to x.
How you can find? Bolo, kaise karoge? 0 to 1. You just forget about the what the things coming out. Forget about that. First, you consider only. You tell me why x varies from 0 to 1. Y varies from this line to this straight line. Yes or no? Y varies from this to this on xz on xz plane.
Z.
Sir,
minus
x to xz.
X plus. So it is
explain from the beginning once again.
You consider this is your x axis, this is your y axis, this is your z axis. Okay.
Yes.
I am writing as x varies from 0 to 1, as x varies from 0 to 1, y varies from where to where?
Sir,
1 0 minus to 1 to minus y.
On the x.
Y varies from?
Varying.
0 to z, sir.
So y will vary on the limit x plus y equals to 1.
Yes. X plus y is equal to 1, no?
Yes, sir.
Why? Y x plus y is equal to 1? Because 1 minus x. Y varies in this plane, xy plane, and here we have z is equal to 0.
Yes, sir.
Here we have z is equal to 0. So if you put z is equal to 0 over here, we are getting x plus y is equal to 1. So x varies from 0 to, y varies from 0 to 1 minus x. So y varies from 0 less than equal to y less than equal to 1 minus x. Up to this, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, so x varies from 0 to 1. X varies from 0 to 1. Y varies from here to here. Now, z varies from this plane to this plane. This front plane, xy, z plane. This plane to this plane. So, in that case, z will vary from starting from 0 to what?
1 minus x minus y.
1 minus x minus y.
1 minus x minus y. So, this is your thing. So, now, sir, we are getting all these three repeated integers.
Sir, explain the rate for z again.
Then y will be 1. When x is equal to 0, then y will be 1.
When x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1.
Then y will move from 1 to 1 minus x.
You no need to see check that we have taken 0 to 1. X varies from 0 to 1. That I have taken. So as x varies from 0 to 1, y varies from 1. Y from 0 to 1 minus x. This line, this plane. The plane is what? X plus y is equal to 1. Z is equal to 0. And then z varies from 0. Z is equal to 0 to up to z is equal to 1 minus x minus y plane. Z varies from 0 to 1 minus x minus y plane. Okay, that's why I have taken 0 to 1 minus x minus y. So you can write the integration is equal to, okay, let me check. Integration you can write, this is x is equal to 0 to 1. Y is equal to 0 to 1 minus x, and z is equal to 0 to 1 minus x minus y, and the integrand is x plus y plus z plus 1 dx dy dz. X equal to 0 to 1, y is equal to 0 to 1 minus x, z is equal to 0 to 1 minus x minus y, and x plus y plus z plus 1 dx dy dz. Now, can you complete this problem? Then I will leave. You just first need to integrate with respect to z first. Simply integrate with respect to z. Then put the range 0 to 1 minus x minus y. Then integrate with respect to y. Put the limit 0 to 1 minus x. Then lastly, integration with respect to x. Put the limit 0 to 1. I am giving the answer. Answer you will get some 117, maybe wrong. I have done up to this 117 by 70. You will be able to get the answer as 117 by 70. I am leaving to you this problem. Okay. So this type of problem will be given, and
sir. Sir, when x varies to 0 to 1, then y varies on the xy plane.
Y varies from xy plane.
And the last one, z, I cannot
see,
0 to 1 minus.
You see, first x varies in a line 0 to 1. Y varies in this plane, xy plane. In this xy plane. Why? Because I am taking here z is equal to 0. You see, first if I consider this one, you need to cover up this area, this volume. You need to cover up this volume. Okay. So for that reason, I am taking for x varies from 0 to 1. Then y varies from this to this line. So it is covering this xy plane, this triangle in the xy plane?
Yes, sir.
Now z varies from this plane. This plane. Let me take another color. Z varies from this plane. This plane to up to this one. This one. Then it will cover this total volume. So for that, so when here we have here this point up to this, when we are here, it will be up to this on this plane like this. So we are actually where z is varying from this plane. This plane actually means z is equal to 0.
Yes, sir.
To this plane. This okay, plane is okay. What? X plus
1 minus y plus x z plus is equal y. To 1.
So that means z is equal to 1 minus x minus y.
Yes, sir. Okay. Now understand.
Fine.
Sir, that means in this type of problem, first we will take x along a line, then y along the same plane, and then z along the volume, right?
Actually, you see, we are from 0 to 1. When I'm saying x is equal to from 0 to 1, that means actually what? We are going through a plane. X is equal to 0 in 3 dimension, what actually represent? A plane.
Yes, sir.
A plane represents. Yes, so x equal to 0 plane to x is equal to 1. Okay. This is also another plane parallel to y z.
Yes, sir.
So 0 to 1. I am writing that x equal to 0 to 1. Actually, I am writing x equal to 0 to 1 means actually from a plane to plane. In double integration, you see, we are moving from a line to line. If you recall, there we are always moving from a line to line. Now here actually we are moving from a plane to plane. To cover a volume, you need some plane, yes or no? Tell me. Forget all this thing. Suppose you are asked to cover an area. You are asked to cover an area. In that case, what you require? You require some line, yes or no? I'm not saying the straight line. Some lines you require. You just draw any region in your paper. And if I ask you to cover this plane, you see always you are varying from one line to another line. To cover a volume, you need to always move from one plane to another plane to cover a some plane requires to cover a volume, so that's why plane. So I am representing like this from x equal to 0 to 1 means what? This plane to this plane actually. X equal to 1, but it's parallel to 1. Then from this plane to this plane for x axis. Then because you see when I say y is equal to 0, this is another plane, and y is equal to 1 minus x, this is another plane. Here I am representing this line. This line means actually what? A plane on this line. A plane on this line. So you are going here, and lastly from this plane, xy plane to this one. You can choose y is equal to 0 to 1 first also, no problem. Accordingly, all will getting changed. In that case, if you take y is equal to 0 to 1, x from 0 to place like this unit. Which thora thora clear hua?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Yes.
Okay. Theek hai. Next. So this type of problems will be given. I will give you a lot of problems. You cross out this. It will be easy. Now, I have 2 minutes. So I am taking a change of variable. Just I will explain. 2-3 lines here. Change of variable means, you see, if I ask you integrate 1 by 1 plus x square dx, what are the value?
Tan inverse.
How we are getting making there a suitable substitution here.
Yes.
X is equal to some?
Tan theta.
X is equal to some sec theta?
Tan theta.
Tan theta.
Tan theta.
Tan theta. Tan theta. Yes. X equal to tan theta if you put, then what you find, dx is equal to compensation of this tan theta, differentiation of tan theta, I'm writing like this, tan theta dash, then
theta.
D theta. Okay, so something, some derivative will coming over here and dx changing to d theta. So from the coordinate x to theta, I am changing like this. Now, if it is a double integration, some double integration, f of xy, dx dy is here. So, here dx changes to d theta. Now, some f of xy is there. I am making some suitable transformation, like suppose x is equal to some phi of uv, some function, and y is equal to some psi of uv. Okay, so in that case, what will be your dx dy? What will be your dx dy? Dx dy will be equal to, here you see dx is equal to tan theta dash into d theta. In differentiation of this tan theta, then d theta. Here, I represent this as some Jacobian. We define Jacobian du dv. This Jacobian value will be given by this del xy by del uv. What does it represent? Del xy by del uv? It is one matrix, Jacobian matrix, that will be del x del u, del x del v, del y del u, del y del v. Remember this. This is known as Jacobian of xy with respect to uv. This is a higher order differentiation. Jacobian, I think you have crossed out all the this Jacobian in several variables, now function of several variables. Have you crossed out?
No, sir.
Okay.
So it
has been excluded from the syllabus, Jacobian.
Okay, so remember the Jacobian definition. I am just writing here the definition of Jacobian and I'll stop. Suppose you have function of several variables, f1, f2, f3, up to fn. Okay. Then Jacobian of this f1, f2, f3, fn with respect to the variables x1, x2, x3, up to xn, where what? This fi is equal to function of x1, x2, up to xn, function of several variable. This fi is equal to f1, f2, for all I is equal to 1 to n. Then this Jacobian matrix is defined as Jacobian of first row will be del f1 by del x1, del f1 by del x2, like this, del f1 by del xn. Next, there will be del f2 by del x1, del f2 by del x2, del f2 by del xn. Like this it will go, and last will be del fn, del x1, del fn by del x2, like this, del fn by del xn. This is called Jacobian matrix, and this is the determinant. If you write mod z, that is actually determinant of this. So you see, if you have n function of several variable with n number of variables, then that should be n cross n Jacobian you will get.
Sir.
Okay.
So suppose we have n minus 1 number of functions and each function is...
In that case, you will not be able to find.
Then we will not able to find the Jacobian.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. It will be always a square matrix then.
Square matrix always. Okay. Yeah. So let me stop here today.